虽然少林功夫名震天下，但他并不崇尚武力，而是以提升修为、强身自卫为目的，也是佛家惩恶扬善又不杀生这一原则的体现。佛家说的禅就是静心，因此少林功夫的最高境界称为武术禅，也就是身怀绝技却心无杂念。由于采用动静结合、禅拳归一的练功方法，少林僧徒养成了一个独特的习惯，在静谧的地方修习武功，因为幽静的环境才能有助于禅武结合，练成真功。对于超常神力的渴望，对于超常智慧的追求，是佛教徒修行的目标。这正是少林功夫的神奇所在，亦是少林功夫与其他武术的根本区别。正是因为有了这样的区别，少林僧徒们形成了自身独特的修炼方式，通过冥想、吐纳等方式，将自身与大自然融为一体。而这种修炼既体现了佛教徒的终极目标，也蕴含着中国传统哲学中天人合一的理念。二指禅是少林专修和特有的功夫，需要从小练习，每天用手指做几百个俯卧撑，练得小孩子的手比大人都大一圈。修炼之人通过日积月累的训练，能够用两个手指支撑起全身的重量。这种用现代物理学原理几乎无法解释的奇特功法令世人惊叹。软功是少林功夫的绝技之一，它挑战的是人体柔韧性的极限。 软功源于印度的瑜伽，但练习的目的却是为了提升功力，提高武功招式的精准度，让每个招式都能发挥更大的威力。只有从小修习童子功的僧人才具备练习软功的身体条件，这样的训练使他们的功力不会像普通习武者一样随着年龄的增长而衰退。这就是为什么许多年迈的高僧依然内功深厚的奥秘所在。在少林寺这个特定的佛教文化空间内，少林功夫不断地被发扬光大。对神秘少林功夫的崇敬与向往，年复一年地驱使着无数的人们登临少室山，一睹少林风采。而少林寺也因为少林功夫而名扬四海。少林武僧团自上世纪八十年代末成立以来，足迹遍及世界各地。他们的精彩表演使得少林功夫受到了国际社会越来越多的关注和赞许，逐步成为中外文化交流的桥梁和纽带。如今，神秘的少林功夫为无数世人所仰慕。少室山下，习武健身已经蔚然成风。 中外武术爱好者们一批批地来到这里，系统地学习少林功夫。经过严格的考核筛选，他们当中最优秀的成员幸运地成为少林武僧，跨入庄严的山门，继续禅武合一的修行。春去秋来，穿越了千年的沧桑，中国的少林寺始终如一地传习着功夫，弘扬着佛法。
To protect themselves, as well as to keep fit. Many believe this was the beginning of the temple's martial arts tradition. The unique Shaolin style of Kung Fu is a blend of Chinese martial arts and the religious fundamentals of Chan Buddhism, which is also known as Zen Buddhism in Japan. Shaolin Kung Fu is an extensive system of martial arts that focuses on a step-by-step progression of movements from easy to difficult. Becoming proficient requires dedication and perseverance. Ancient Kung Fu manuals at the temple show that there were originally 708 sets of Shaolin Kung Fu movements. 522 of these involved boxing and weapons. Another 156 consisted of dogfighting, wrestling, grappling, and a form of breath and energy control called Qigong. Monks living at Shaolin Temple today actually only practice about 200 of these original martial arts sets. The monk's morning workout ushers in an entire day of exercise. In addition to basic training that builds endurance and strength, the monks practice different types of kung fu skills, depending on their individual needs. They all know that progress in martial arts comes only through hard work over a long period of time. Plum Blossom Pole. Years of repetitive practice underlines the powerful Shaolin Kung Fu that is so dazzling to watch. The monks repeat each movement thousands of times in daily practice. Through this repetition, basic techniques become astonishing skills. Leaping onto roofs and vaulting over walls, he is representative of Shaolin's light body skills. The monks who have mastered this technique pass over mountainous terrain as easily as if they were walking on even ground. Because the temple is located in the mountains, Shaolin monks always had to traverse steep and uneven trails wherever they went. Over time, in the course of adapting themselves to their surroundings, as well as form the needs to protect themselves, they develop powerful and nimble footwork. Usually it takes 3 years to master the plum blossom pole technique, 4 years for the iron sand palm form, and 5 to be proficient in leaping onto roofs and vaulting over walls. Of all the Shaolin techniques, hard Qigong is by far the most mysterious and sophisticated. Through diligent and demanding practice, a monk can gradually raise his body's ability to endure strikes, and eventually, he possesses an almost supernatural power of endurance. Chinese Kung Fu emphasizes control and movement of one's qi, or vital energy. Through regulating the breath and concentrating attention on a certain part of the body, one is actually able to sum up all the qi. Once a monk has mastered hard Qigong, the part of his body where he concentrates his qi becomes as hard as iron, allowing him to endure physical assault that others cannot. Monks usually start out learning Young Boys Kung Fu. The basic requirement of practicing all the forms of Shaolin Kung Fu are suppleness, flexibility, strength, and endurance. Generally speaking, the suppler one is, the greater one's endurance becomes. And the earlier one begins training, the easier it is to gain control over the body. The optimum age to start training is 5 or 6. This means that to master Shaolin Kung Fu techniques completely, a practitioner must usually start in childhood. Sparring is one of the best ways to improve one's Shaolin Kung Fu. Under sudden attack from a real opponent, the martial artist has to learn how to defend himself by moving quickly in response to the attacker's tactics. These split-second responses are difficult to master, but sparring is a perfect way to practice both the defensive and offensive moves of Shaolin Kung Fu. Imitation boxing is the most animated of the Shaolin boxing arts. It is based on the movements of animals who have adapted well to their natural surroundings. By imitating the animals' movements, the Shaolin monks invented a unique and amusing form of boxing. Monkey boxing, the lift, leaps, and scratches of the cheeks make monkey boxing performers look as agile as they do mischievous. Dragon boxing. Nobody knows what the legendary dragon really looks like, but dragon boxing is a physical expression of the dragon's mysterious, volatile nature. Mantis boxing. Don't underestimate the effectiveness of this martial arts form. Strong, explosive power underlies these graceful and steady movements.